Guys, Mitel, think of it like Gong, but for Asia Pacific, plus extra things added on top of Gong. He's got over 1,600 paying customers, doing over $1.6 million a month in revenue, up from $800,000 a month just a year ago. Done this very capital efficient. They raised $15 million in a Series A at called $150 million valuation back in 2020 and hasn't raised since. So very efficient growth, 200 on the team, 80 engineers, 30 sales reps, 120, 110 plus net dollar retention as he TK looks to scale. Hey folks, my guest today is TK. After joining Mitsubishi Corporation, he was involved in automotive trading, planning, and executing sales and marketing initiatives in overseas markets, cross-border investment deals, and new company formations, among many other things. He founded RevCom in July 2017, which provides a self-coaching tool called Mitel and Mitel for Zoom, a service that uses artificial intelligence to visualize sales calls, call center operations, and meetings. The company has expanded to more than 40,000 users in 4 years among Japan, Indonesia, the Philippines, and the US. TK, you ready to take us to the top?
Yep.
All right.
Hey, how's it going?
Good to meet you, man. So just to be clear, is RevCom a parent company with a bunch of companies, or is the main thing Mitel?
Main thing Mitel. It's the company name is RevCom. It's a RevCom Inc. And our service is Mitel and Mitel for Zoom.
Okay, so the website, if you want to follow along, will be revcom.co.jp, right?
Yeah.
All right, very good.
We have LP, like, you know, Mitel.com.
That's great. All right, yep. So let's talk about Mitel.com, right? Mm-hmm. So what does the product do and what kinds of customers are you selling to?
Yeah, it's, B2B SaaS self-coaching tool, very simple service. It analyzes and visualizes the sales and shares competition by artificial intelligence in terms of what and how. So in terms of how, We visualize talk recent ratio, number of silences, overlaps. Overlaps means an interruption, by the way. And number of silences, rallies. Rallies means a composition back and forth, and speech rate. How many characters per second operator spoke, and customer did. So for example, in terms of speech rate, it is said that pacing is important in sales or CS. Pacing means you're supposed to talk plus minus 10% of the customer, because there's a strong correlation between brain speed and speech rate. So if you speak too fast, the customer can't understand. And if you speak too slowly, customer
I
is
think you're
get
stupid.
Bored, right? Yeah. So that's why you're supposed to talk plus minus 10% of the customer. In this way, you can see how the communication was made and where the issues are. And in terms of what, we transcribe the whole conversation and summarize it and automatically input it into CRM as FA. So that's what we do.
TK, can you do syntax analysis, happy, sad, things like this?
Yeah. We analyze the emotion as well.
Interesting. Yeah. Okay, very cool. I mean, what this reminds me of? I mean, it feels like you're effectively Gong, but for Asia. I mean, is that a fair comparison or no?
Yeah, it's a fair comparison. Okay. So the difference between Gong, Koras, and Mitel is that very simple. The Mitel equal Gong plus, Zoom phone or Dialpad and Ring Central, which is IP phone. So Mitel consists of two parts, right? IP phone, cloud IP phone, plus conversation analytics. So it's a one-stop service. And we provide it with only $79. And Gong costs you, $100 to $140. So
it's 70. I see. You're very clear on your website. It's $69 or $70 per month. Is that per user per seat?
Yeah, per user per seat. Yeah. Okay. Per user per month. Yeah.
Oh, what's going on there, YouTube? Good to see you guys. Now imagine this. You love watching these interviews with SaaS founders, but imagine if we took all of the valuation data out from over 2,807 interviews I've done manually. Saves you a lot of time. Well, we've done this. We've built it into the beautiful interface inside of FounderPath. Check this out. I'll show you how you can access this in a second, but you log in, you connect your Stripe account, you see your valuation real time, you can see what it changed over the past 88 days, and even set goals for valuation this year. Now, the secret to valuation is there's many different ways to value a SaaS business. So the reason you're going to see three or four different valuations inside of your FounderPath dashboard, this is all free, by the way, is because depending on who's doing the buying of your SaaS company, you're going to get a different valuation. A VC is going to pay a different valuation. Private equity firm is different. If you're going to do a minority sale, that's different. And if you sell the whole business, that's a different valuation. You can see all those when I hover over here. Right. So the teal is what a VC would pay. Yellow is what private equity. And red is if you sold the whole thing outright. Now, what's cool about this is not built off random data. Again, you guys hear these interviews on YouTube. All these data are built from real-time valuation data points founders share with us on the show. So Traction, 1.2 million, seed round, 3.7 raise. They sold 22% of their business. Go in here and filter by the event. Maybe you only want to see companies that have sold the whole business. Well, here are a bunch that have been acquired, the valuation and the multiple. Maybe you're going out right now and you're raising your seed round. Well, go in here and look at all this recent seed deals that went down, what they raised, what valuation they raised at, and what percent that they sold. There's never been a larger data set of SaaS valuations than what you can get now inside of FounderPath, and we're thrilled to bring it to you. All right, we're gonna go back to the YouTube video here in a second, but if you wanna check this tool out, if you wanna jump in and sign up, you can check it out for free to get your valuation at this link, founderpath.com/products/valuations. Or if you go to founderpath.com and hover over products, click on get your valuation here, and go ahead and sign up to give it a whirl. Again, all that valuation data live right inside the platform. I hope to see you there. All right, let's jump back into the interview. What does the average sort of company pay per month? This will be driven by obviously the number of seats they're paying for, their team size.
It totally depends. But in Japan, enterprise customer pays us usually like, you know, $140 per month per ID. Including, you know, cold charge and mobile app, you know, options, and also storage options, you know. So $69, it includes 2 months of recording, you know, storage. But enterprise users usually store their, you know, recorded data more than, you know, 12 months.
Yep.
So they have to pay the storage fee.
Yep. That makes a lot of sense. It's a smart upsell. But if you look at your, not just your enterprise cohort, if you just look at all of your paying businesses today, is it fair to say the average business is paying something like $500 to $1,000 a month?
Yeah.
That'd be pretty like much. 4 or 5 seats basically.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Interesting.
So it's you know, industry diagnostic, from financial industry to manufacturer, from listed company to SMB.
Yeah.
It's a horizontal SaaS.
This is great. Okay. I understand what you charge. I understand the product. Put this on a timeline for us. When did you launch the business?
We launched Meetel in 2018, November. So it's been about 4 years and 3 months or so.
And are you the only founder?
Yeah, I'm the solo founder.
That's cool. That's the way to do it, man, right? Now, are you already super rich? You put up your own money or what?
Well, not really. I mean, what I'd like to do in the future is, like, you know, I'd like to spend my time and social network to the philanthropic you know, activity. So most of the share is owned by, you know, my foundation. It's called the Think Act Foundation and Takeshi Aida Foundation. Mm-hmm. So 90% of my share is owned by that foundation.
And do you do that because of from a tax strategy perspective, that's smart tax planning?
Yes and no. I'm willing to pay a tax to the Japanese you know, government. For the, you know, society, for the society, right?
What is the average tax rate in Japan? If you sell the business for $1 billion and you own all the equity, how much you're going to pay the Japanese government?
Yeah, capital gain tax is 20%. So it's not that much.
It's lower than some spots in the U.S. So,
right. So, you know, the tax strategy is not that important for the capital gain.
So you get going here in 2018. Now, did you write the original code or did you convince an engineer to write it for you?
I convinced engineer write for me. Yeah. So
you're very convincing then. How did you do that?
There's no, you know, secret sauce. It's keep communicating with a lot of engineers. But my findings at early stage was that there are 4 types of engineers, right? The engineer who was strong at you know, structure, architecture, and algorithm, and application, and management, right? And so what Ali stage founder should find is an architecture engineer who are strong at architecture engineer. Because if the architecture is not well architected, then you have to rebuild in at some point. Usually business person seeking the application engineer, because application engineer is very, very well known.
Yep.
So the engineer who made this service, right? And
did you just pay him or her a lot of money, or did you give him equity?
Equity plus money.
What does an art, I mean, don't tell me the salary of your first hire, but in general, an architecture engineer in Japan today, I mean, what are you going to pay them per year in salary?
Well, it totally depends. So at first I paid them only, $5,000 per month.
Yeah.
Plus stock option. Right.
But we're talking like under 5% equity, right?
Yeah, on the 5% equity.
I mean, sure. That's still impressive that you're able to recruit someone that you feel like is pretty talented for $5,000 a month plus under a 5% option grant. I mean, he must or she must have just really believed in your vision.
Yeah, that's a point, right?
But why? Why did he believe you? I mean, is this your second or third company? How did you build his or her confidence?
Enthusiasm, man. It's all about enthusiasm. Dream, vision, and also engineer really care about logical strategy, right? So how are you gonna make the business bigger, and what's your tactics and what's your strategy? You have to be very logical. So it's a balance of enthusiasm and logic. Yep. It's all about that. Yeah.
That's the origin story. You get going in 2018. We put out a report every year, the fastest growing SaaS companies. We found you. You give us results. I don't want to steal your thunder here. So I'll let you share, right? What's revenue today and how fast did you grow the last 12 months?
We are not disclosing the revenue.
You gave it to us already publicly.
It's a beyond T2 D3 cop, which is triple triple double double double.
And oh yeah, but that's a non-answer.
Estimate.
let me ask you this question. Instead of a revenue figure, do you get your first customers in 2018, or did it take you a couple of years to get the first customer?
2018, we had at the first of launching, we already have 30 companies.
How'd you do that?
I went to a Salesforce event and keep talking, hey, we are self-coaching tool, and if you're interested, why don't you use a closed beta version, and then when we officially launch, you can turn it to paid customer. So
that's amazing
what I did.
What was your initial price point? Was it always $69 a month?
No, at first it was $49. Because the function was very limited. We didn't have any emotion detection engine. Also, we didn't have a transcription engine. We only have how to speak engine, like tokenization ratio, noble silences, overlaps, and speech break. That's it. But customers' willingness to pay with how to speak engine was $59. So. I
30 customers because you're hustling at a Salesforce conference, you get 30 signed up. Now fast forward today, 3 years later, how many customers are you working with?
We have number of company is 1600. Yeah.
Okay. And you mentioned earlier, the average one pays about $1,000 a month, right? I mean, so we can sort of, you're doing somewhere around $1.5 million a month in revenue.
You can guess.
Well, I'm not guessing. I'm multiplying your numbers. You told me earlier your average ARPU was $1,000 a month, and you just told me your customers were 1600. Is there any reason I couldn't just multiply those?
Yeah. Well, average ARPA, average revenue per account is more than $1,000. So
you're doing more than 1.6 million a month right now on revenue.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good enough. You're at above that range today. Where were you exactly a year ago, so we can calculate a growth rate?
It's half of it.
Okay, so you've grown 100% over the past 12 months. That's great. Now, did you do this bootstrapped, or have you raised a bunch of capital?
We raised approximately $15 3 years ago, and since then we have not raised any money.
Sorry, you
so
raised
it's a capital efficient.
You raised how much?
15 million USD.
Oh, million. Okay, I thought you said you raised $15. Got it.
Yeah.
So you raised that money in 2020? You said?
No, 2020. It was 2020. Yeah, 3 years ago.
And why did you need to raise that money? What about this business is capital intensive?
Well, to accelerate hiring and also sales marketing expense, I'd like to raise approximately 10 million. But for the 10 million call, 50 million, 50 million has knock us. So I have to arrange who to welcome, and end up with the 15 million.
Yeah, that's fair. Now, would you consider that sort of your Series A?
Yeah, Series A.
Yeah. I mean, most people in their Series A, they're selling between 10% and 15% of the business. Were you sort of in that same range?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, so it's like 150 million valuation, something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Very good. And do you remember what revenue was back in 2020?
It was like approximately 200K MRR.
Okay. Yeah. So did that valuation back then feel fair to you? Would you do anything differently?
Yeah, it was fair. For sure.
Yeah, I mean, what is that? 150 divided by 2.4. That was a 62x multiple. I mean, back then.
Pretty much.
Back then, that was market. Today, that would be very aggressive.
Yeah. Yeah, market has been changed totally.
Are you in a position right now to sort of outlast the recession, or are you burning a bunch? You need to go raise money this year.
We don't have to raise money. We are still capital efficient. So
that's awesome. That's awesome. So what's the target this year? I mean, do you think you can break a 30 million run rate, 35 million run rate this year?
Less than that run rate. I mean, burn rate, right?
No. What do you think you can hit this year in terms of revenue?
Well, we'd like to double it for sure.
Okay. So you think you can get over $40 million in revenue run rate this year?
Pretty much.
That would be aggressive, but a little uncomfortable, but doable.
Yeah, I think it's doable in terms of we are expanding, our market, not only in Japan, but also Indonesia, Philippines, and the U.S. Yeah.
Henry Schuck went out and acquired Chorus recently. Well, called a year and a half, 2 years ago, for about $450 million. I imagine he's aggressively looking at Asia. I imagine you've had to have conversations with folks in terms of M&A. Are you in any conversations right now to sell the business?
Not really, but we are open every time. Mm-hmm. I actually talked with ex-founder of Chorus.
Roy or who?
Yeah, Roy. Yeah.
Yeah.
You know Roy?
Of course.
He's a nice
Nathan Lacken knows everybody. Come on.
Yeah.
I mean, look, an interesting target. You're an interesting target for ZoomInfo. You're an interesting target for a meet at Gong. Like anyone that wants to expand to Asia Pacific, I would say you are like a prime target. You're very well positioned because you're so capital efficient.
Yeah.
Your ARR is more than, correct me if this is wrong, you have more ARR today, revenue, than the total amount of money you've raised.
Yeah, for sure. Of course.
So you're very capital efficient, which makes you a prime target.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. No, I love that. That's great. How many folks are full-time on the team today?
200 people approximately.
How many engineers?
40%.
Okay, got it. So call that
8,200. Yeah,
80 engineers. Yeah, how many sales reps with the quota?
30.
And how aggressive are quotas over there? And I mean, is it a million a year is what you want them to do?
Per rep. Yeah.
Is that it? That's what you have yours set at, $1 million quota for your top reps?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Do all of them hit it?
No. Only 20%.
But okay. Well, you're okay with
they're
that.
Using, self coaching to a Mitel. So
that's fair.
Yeah.
That's fair. Okay, very good. And then I guess look, net dollar retention is obviously a critical component of a SaaS business. Are you guys above 100% today? And if so, how far?
Yeah,
above?
For sure. Yeah. Yeah. Our key metrics is NRR. So we'd like to maximize. It's over 100%. It's
are you above
between 100 to 150? Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, that's a big world class, as I would say, 140 or above.
It's less than 140. Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. But you're between 100, you know, call it 110 and 140, somewhere in there.
Yeah. Yeah. Somewhere around that.
Very cool. Well, listen, this is a great story. I appreciate you making time. We're out of time though for today. Let's wrap up with the famous five. Number one, favorite book.
I love, you know, philosophy. I like the Kant, Critique of Pure Reason. That's my favorite book. Yeah.
That's the one, the Copt. Number two, is there a CEO you're following or studying?
I would say my dad. But what I respect most is Bill Gates.
Bill Gates. Number three, what's your favorite online tool besides your own for building Meetel?
I would say Slack. Without Slack, I cannot do work. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, number four, how many hours of sleep do you get every night?
Usually 6 hours.
Okay, and what's your situation? Married, single kids?
Married with one daughter.
Oh, that's great.
Pretty daughter.
That's awesome. How old are you?
I'm 33.
33. Last question. Something you wish you knew when you were 20.
When I was 20?
When you were 20 years old.
I don't know. Start my business earlier. I started my business when I was 28. I should start much earlier.
Guys, Meetel, think of it like Gong, but for Asia Pacific, plus extra things added on top of Gong. He's got over 1,600 paying customers, doing over $1.6 million a month in revenue, up from $800,000 a month just a year ago. Done this very capital efficient. They raised $15 million bucks in a Series A at called $150 million valuation back in 2020 and hasn't raised since. So very efficient growth, 200 on the team, 80 engineers, 30 sales reps, 110 plus net dollar retention as TK looks to scale. Very exciting space. TK, thanks for taking us to the top.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to talk to you.
One more thing before you go. We have a brand new show every Thursday at 1 p.m. Central. It's called Shark Tank for SaaS. We call it Deal or Bust. One founder comes on, three hungry buyers. They try and do a deal live, and the founder shares back-end dashboards, their expenses, their revenue, ARPU, CAC, LTV, you name it, they share it. And the buyers try and make a deal live. It is fun to watch every Thursday, 1 p.m. Central. Additionally, remember, these recorded founder interviews go live. We release them here on YouTube every day at 2 p.m. Central. To make sure you don't miss any of that, make sure you click the subscribe button below here on YouTube, the big red button, and then click the little bell notification to make sure you get notifications when we do go live. I wouldn't want you to miss breaking news in the SaaS world, whether it's an acquisition, a big fundraise, a big sale, a big profitability statement, or something else. I don't want you to miss it. Additionally, if you want to take this conversation deeper and further, we have by far the largest private Slack community for B2B SaaS founders. You want to get in there. We've probably talked about your tool if you're running a company, or your firm if you're investing. You can go in there and quickly search and see what people are saying. Sign up for that at nathanlatka.com/Slack. In the meantime, I'm hanging out with you here on YouTube. I'll be in the comments for the next 30 minutes. Feel free to let me know what you thought about this episode. And if you enjoyed it, click the thumbs up. We get a lot of haters that are mad at how aggressive I am on these shows, but I do it so that we can all learn. We have to counter those people. We got to push them away. Click the thumbs up below to counter them and know that I appreciate your guys' support. All right. I'll be in the comments. See ya.